All right, so yeah, good morning and good evening, everyone, according to your time zone. I'm your host, Sushant, and today we are starting our third session from our Salesforce Marketing Cloud series by Pankaj Namdeo. So I guess most of you already know Pankaj. He's quite active on LinkedIn and really popular in this marketing cloud area in Salesforce. So a brief intro about Pankaj. So Pankaj is a Salesforce marketing cloud consultant, currently working in Mar Labs. He's also a Salesforce marketing cloud trainer. And along with that, he's also a runner. So guys, in this series, this is the third session of this series. And we already wrapped up two sessions. So if any one of you have missed any sessions from this series, you can visit our website. I will share the link in upcoming slides. So you can visit over there and you can go through with the past sessions. Quick intro about me. I am your host today. I'm Sushant, working in NCR Corporation as a senior software engineer, leading this new Delhi developer group since last 1 year. Apart from that, I'm also a platform champion, Gentoo Salesforce mentor, and creator and founder of Talent Central portal, where we give opportunity to students to get their jobs. Also, I'm working in Salesforce domain since last 4 years and associated with many initiatives. Most of them are running by New Delhi Developer Group itself, and some of the groups are running by other community groups and as well as our Indian Dev Relation team. So who we are? We are New Delhi Developer Group. So we came in existence in early Feb 2016. We are very active on Twitter. This is our hashtag for this particular Impact Salesforce Saturday initiative. So also we are also active on Salesforce Trailblazer community. Along with that, we have our official website, which is newdelhisfdcdug.com. So this is the website where you can find our all past sessions. And also if you want to be our volunteer, or if you want to share your blogs with us, you can visit that website and you can register with us. Impact Salesforce Saturday. So as you know, New Delhi Developer Group is quite active in Trailblazer community, and we are running lots of initiative for our Salesforce Ohana. One of them is Impact Salesforce Saturday. So it's basically a series of online sessions brought by New Delhi Developer Group 4 years back. And previously, it was known as a virtual Salesforce Saturday, but last year we have rebranded it and we called it as a Impact Salesforce Saturday. So in 2020, we hosted more than 60 plus sessions, and more than 4,000 participants joined us, and more than 30 plus participants got certified from this initiative. And you can check out these links for our past sessions, what we already covered under this Impact Salesforce Saturday initiative. And also, if you want to see our future sessions, so we already scheduled a few of them for you. So you can visit this link and you can check out them as well. Talent Central. Talent Central is one of our newest initiatives. We brought in terms of community last year. So it's like a matchmaking site for students as well as HR. So if you are a fresher and you are looking fresher, or a student having a less than 1 year experience, so they can register over there and they can look, then can create their profiles. At the same time, HRs from different Salesforce partner companies, they can register also over there, and they will shortlist your profiles on the basis of the data you have filled. So to register over there. And if you already have your profile on Talent Center portal, so I will urge everyone to please update your profile on daily basis so that it will increase more chances to shortlist your resume very easily. This is our official link, talentcentralglobal.com. So you can visit over there. And if you are not registered till now, you can register there as well. Again, this year, we have launched one of our new initiative called Let's Implement. So currently, what we as a group saw a challenge in the community, like people have batches, people have their super batches, people have their certifications, but since they are new and they don't have lots of hands-on. So due to this, many of you are not able to succeed in interviews, and that's why and you face challenge to get your job. So we brought an initiative which mainly focus on the hands-on, and we are sure to launch the first session or first batch of mentees where some experts work with New Delhi Developer Group as a mentor, and they will teach 30 mentees in February and help them to build their first project, which is a real-time project, so that you can put it in your resume. And along with that, if you want to learn, then you can check out our Impact Sales for Saturday sessions. And when you completed your hands-on projects, then you can build your profile on Talent Central, and HRs definitely shortlist your profile from there, because now you have knowledge and as well as you have a hands-on experience also with this Let's Implement initiative. So this is our official web link for Let's Implement. If you want to know more about this initiative, you can visit this link. And also after that, if you also have more queries, then you can connect with me, or you can drop an email to New Delhi SFD, New Delhi official Gmail ID. So I will share all the links with you in between the session. Again, this is not a journey to Salesforce. You are all aware this is not an New Delhi Developer Group initiative. This is an initiative brought by our awesome Indian Dev Relation team. So it's basically a series of trail mixes. So you have to complete this trail mixes. And at the end of every month, Dev Relation team will organize a event, Journey to Salesforce event, where if you are facing any challenges while completing this trail mixes, you can ask the questions directly to the experts in that session. And along with that, this initiative also consists of Employer Connect program, where if you have already completed the J2S journey, then you can participate in Employer Connect program. And you, in order to participate that, your resume should be shortlisted, which is taken care by our Dev Relation team. So if your resume, if your profile got shortlisted, then you will get a notification or email from Dev Relation team that please share your resume with us. So then you have to share your resume, and they will connect you with the different Salesforce partner companies, and you will get a chance to work in any of the company. But the difference between Talent Central initiative and Journey to Salesforce initiative is that this particular program is not for students or not for freshers having experience less than 1 year. This particular program is only for the experienced people who are not the part of Salesforce ecosystem as of now. They have some experience in other technologies like .NET, Java, Oracle, SAP, all this. So this initiative is basically for them. This initiative is not for students. There are lots of confusion going on still in the community. And that's why I just want to clear, like if you are a student, you can still, Trailhead is open for everyone. You can still complete all the trail mixes. You can still complete all the content what this initiative will provide, but you are not eligible for Employer Connect program, and you are also not eligible for incentives for this program will provide. But yes, you can, learning never stops you. Trailhead is open for you, so you can anytime you can complete these trail mixes. Again, last but not the least, these are our volunteers. So kudos to them. A big shout out to everyone. So thank you so much, everyone, for all your support and all your help. Without you, it won't be possible to conduct sessions every week. And so all credit goes to our awesome volunteers. More faces, Aman, Adhuri, Lalit, Akshaya, Praveen, Shalini, Divya. So they are doing an awesome job for us. So thanks, guys. Thank you so much for all your support. So you can take a screenshot of this slide. These are some links where you can easily reach out to us. And we are very active on Telegram as well. So this is our first channel where you will get all the latest update, not for our sessions only, but all the latest trend going on, or all the initiatives going on in our community. So we will share all these kind of details as well. So you can definitely connect with us on Telegram if you're not connected till now. Again, I will wrap up my slides with this last session, which is very important. I would like to thank our sponsors, Cloud Vandana and Grey Opus. Thank you so much, guys, for all your support. And without you also, it won't be possible to arrange all the resources which is required to conduct these virtual sessions every week. Kudos to Atul. He's the founder of Cloud Vandana for all his support, for providing all the resources which is necessary to conduct these sessions, the Kahoot, the Zoom, and all these things. So all these things are managed by Atul, the Cloud Vandana founder. So thank you so much. And also Grey Opus as well for helping us in for managing other resources. So thank you so much, guys, for all your support. With that, I would wrap up my introduction things, and I will hand it over the session to Pankaj. So Pankaj, over to you.
Okay. Thanks, Sushant, for that wonderful intro. As ever, you guys are doing a great job out there. Okay, so what do we do today? So can I see a simple yes or one to see how excited we are to start this session number 3, which is about Journey Builder? Come on, guys, can I see one? Yes, excited. Because we are at the third leg of this 4-series journey. And Journey Builder is one of the very key and talked about module in marketing cloud world. So we are going to talk about Journey Builder. Great. I can see that excitement. Okay, so let's quickly jump onto our slide pack. And I'll share my screen. Okay, I hope you can see my screen, and I will zoom it a bit. Okay, great. So what we are covering today, Journey Builder. Who has not heard about Journey Builder in Marketing Cloud? Let me ask this question first. Who hasn't heard about Journey Builder? Anybody out there who hasn't heard about Journey Builder? I'm not asking about whether they know it or not, but whether they have heard about it or not. Okay. I'm getting some yes. I'm not sure it's from a previous one, but answer in yes or no. Simple. Whether you have heard about Journey Builder or not. At least heard somewhere talking about it in Google. Great. Heard about it. So people are aware that Journey Builder is there. That's fine. Great. Okay, so before that, a quick announcement from my side. How many of you are, before getting into the details of Journey Builder, and you to see what exactly lies beneath the hood or the name of Journey Builder, I wanted to have a quick announcement to make. In the last week of February, I'm planning to have a workshop. This is a LinkedIn-based workshop where we, or rather I will be talking about how I have leveraged LinkedIn in order to spread my knowledge and to obtain a certain level of confidence in the Salesforce or marketing cloud community. So prior to that, one quick question, and I would be great if you can answer that. How many of you want to spread your knowledge on LinkedIn specifically as a platform, or you want to have some inbound leads? When I say inbound leads, basically getting offers on LinkedIn, job offers, help request, people asking for help on LinkedIn, or creating a very strong profile, which actually is talking about how do I network in LinkedIn. So basically, what I want to know is anybody struggling or want to have more information on that? Because last week of February, I am planning to have a 1-hour workshop. Date and time is yet to be finalized, but I wanted to take a quick dip over here in this session to understand how many of you are in that boat on which I was traveling some time back. And if that is the case, can I get yes over here? Can I get a yes if people are interested to understand LinkedIn? And it's a totally free workshop. The idea is that I want to train people or help people on how to optimize usage of LinkedIn for specifically for Salesforce background people. This is not a generic digital marketing issue. It's all about LinkedIn ecosystem only. And if that is the case, then what I'll be doing is certainly I'll be sharing my credentials on LinkedIn only. You can connect with me on LinkedIn, and I will be circulating pretty soon the details of that workshop. But to give you a brief of what will be covered, and if you are interested, please get in touch with me on LinkedIn if you are not already. And by the way, I am extremely sorry. A couple of you have actually connected with me on LinkedIn and asked a couple of questions. Unfortunately, due to my bandwidth issue, I'm not able to respond, but I will certainly respond to each and every one of you. That's a promise. So considering this workshop, what I'll be covering, as you all know, gaining knowledge is one part of it, and exposing that knowledge to the world is another part of it. And that's where the real magic lies. Okay, so I'm talking about the other half as to how to do it on LinkedIn. So it will cover certain aspects like your profile optimization, how to connect to different people or influencers or people who are expert in their fields, how to do that introduction, how to actually spread the knowledge, how to actually make sure that you are interacting or creating a communication channel with the experts or influencers or your fellow community trailblazers. All these will be covered with actionable insights of how to do it. Not only the gyan of it, that you should do it this way, also giving some templates alongside the way that this is how you should do it. Use these templates to do that. So I'll be covering all that aspect in that 1-hour power pack workshop. So if you want to be a part of that workshop, which will be in the last week of February, that please get in touch with me. I will be exposing that details pretty soon on my LinkedIn page, and get in touch with me via that LinkedIn, my profile, and I'll be happy to admit you in that workshop. Remember, it's a limited people workshop. I don't want to expose it to 100 or 50 people. It's only 25 people that I'll be allowing, so that I can have one-to-one interaction. I can talk to people and resolve their queries rather than just a one-way communication. So 25 people only required in that. First in, first in, first out. That's it. So all good. Let's move on. So we were talking about Journey Builder, and I have seen that people have mentioned that they have heard of Journey Builder, not necessarily are aware. So what is Journey Builder? And a quick recap of session number 2 that happened for everybody's convenience. We spoke about Content Builder. What are the different content blocks that you can create? It could be of template, dynamic email, enhanced ones. It could be of image, carousel, etc., etc. So these are the different content builder that we spoke about, and we saw hands-on on that. So that was one. Then it is Email Studio. We looked into what is Email Studio. Email Studio is a place where you can create the email content. You can create the data structure, which is about data extensions, and then how to utilize various publication lists, suppression lists, etc., etc. over there. So that we saw in last week, that is, I think, week 6, 23rd, if I'm not wrong. Yes, 23rd of January. So what is a journey builder? This is a big definition that I have shamelessly copy-pasted from LinkedIn. Sorry, Trailhead, but I'll explain you what it means. So basically, it's a feature in within the umbrella of Marketing Cloud. And what it does is it helps you to actually it does campaign planning and execution. What is a campaign? Campaign is a series of steps you do in order to market your brand. The campaign could be an email campaign. It could be a campaign that you are running as a part of your trade shows, physical trade shows going out. So that is a campaign. So it will help you. Please don't do that. Thank you. So it will help you to actually do it in a better automated way. And of course, it is also, Journey Builder also helps you to interact with your customers in one-to-one way. What does it mean? It means that you have the customer can, the journey or the system can adapt to how the customer is behaving, whether he's opening the email, he's clicking on a certain link. Based on that, you can define the journey. So that is called one-to-one interaction. Now, some of the facets of Journey Builder, it is multi-channeled. Basically, you can use multi-channel, as I explained earlier as well. Multi-channel means various channel. What is a channel? It could be email. It could be SMS. It could be in-app push notification. So these are different channels through which we communicate with the customers. Okay? Then it is responsive. It is tailor-made for the customers in the real-time event. So if you have made a purchase, you can send an email with the help of Journey Builder. So it's basically responsive of what you are doing. So that is another facet or aspect of Journey Builder. The last one in this is adaptive. As I briefly spoke about, what I mean by adaptive is that based on the fact that somebody has opened or somebody has not opened, the journey can adapt to the engagement scenarios of the users or the customers or the subscriber. So that is what Journey Builder is all about, at least theoretically. In some time, we'll jump onto the Marketing Cloud org and see how it actually works. So that is Journey Builder for you, definition wise. Next, I would like to cover a very important question, or I would say a confusion out there in the community, that what should I use, Automation Studio or Journey Builder? What is an Automation Studio? Automation Studio is nothing but a tool or within the Marketing Cloud platform that helps you to do multiple things. And one of the very important things that it helps you to do is to segment the data, to transfer the data. And of course, it helps you to email just like Journey Builder, but with a certain variance, and multiple other activities. But the basic use case of automation is more towards doing data segmentation, data related activities, as we call it ETL tool, or slicing and dicing of data. So that is what it's more geared towards. Journey Builder is on the other side, it's geared towards interacting with customers one-to-one basis. So those two have their different worlds in which they live and they operate. So there is no, either I should use Automation Studio or Journey Builder. And I'm talking in general sense. There could be some specific use cases which would remove this perception, but on a general sense, because since I'm talking for everybody's benefit. So Journey Builder, and as I said, they live in both different universes, but it's not a matter of either automation or Journey Builder. It's a matter of actually using them together in order to complete the whole use case. So like, for example, the data coming from an external system can be pulled into a data extension with the help of Automation Studio. And then Journey Builder can pick that data and start running the campaigns. So that's how the use case is Automation Studio and Journey Builder work as complementary to each other rather than against each other. So that's what we have seen in our experience, and I would like to share that with you. So that is the biggest misconception I wanted to clear from the beginning, that it's not either automation and journey builder or journey builder, it's automation and journey builder. That's how we should actually think of these tools, although they are existing separately and using the, doing their own different bit in the universe, marketing cloud universe or ecosystem, but they should be, or most of the times in advanced use cases, at least they are used in conjunction. Okay, so that was about this one. Then, okay. So excited everybody to get into marketingcloud.org. Can I get yes? Great. So I think there was one of the questions that can we send emails? Yes, we can send automation emails, emails via Automation Studio, which I'll be covering in session number 4, that is next Saturday in detail. Okay, let me click on to Journey Builder. Where do I find Journey Builder? And let me zoom it a bit. Okay, so Journey Builder is existing. If I come on Marketing Cloud landing page, okay, so this is where the Journey Builder is. Under this icon, I click on Journey Builder and it opens the page. Okay, so this is how a landing page of a Journey Builder looks like, where it gives you option to store the journeys in different folders, and all the journeys based on the statuses are existing over here. And this is a typical page where it gives you a gist of all the journeys that you have created till now. What kind of journeys is there? Is it single, recent, transactional? I'll talk about it in brief. And first of all, I'll start with the folder structure. So you can create different journeys and place it in different folder structure. Remember, there are multiple teams who will be creating these journeys. So as a best practice, you should always recommend that the journey should be created in a folder structure which is mimicking your organization. It could be marketing, within marketing, it could be outbound, it could be, for example, email, it could be, for example, SMS. Create folder structure similar to that aspect and store journeys accordingly. So as a best practice, what is schedule single sends? Single sends are one shot journeys. So for example, if you want to send a one time email, that is single send. Single send, as the name suggests. The example could be birthday emails. That can happen, of course, multiple times in years, but at least one time, yes. Or it could be recent journey, single sends. That is a recent single send. So that is a recent ones. That's okay. Next one is transactionals. What is a transactional? Transactional ones are the journeys which are triggered as a part of some transaction, as the name suggests, transaction done by you. So for example, if you made a purchase on the website, this transactional journey will get triggered and that journey will be created under this folder structure. So these are the folder structures that are there out of the box. And on top, of course, you can search amongst those journeys, tag those journeys, filter those journeys, see those goals, whether they have met or not. So all those basic things are there as a part of your landing page. Now, let's move on. What do I do next? On top, there are some of other tabs as well. What are the different entry sources? I'll talk about it. Then this is historic journey details. And then these are the templates. Templates is pre-configured journeys provided by Salesforce Marketing Cloud that are existing and you can reuse them. So for example, anniversary send. If you want to create a journey which is of, you want to target anniversary, sending emails on their anniversary, use this. Abandoned cart. Abandoned cart is something that you made, you went to Amazon, you put a product or an item in the cart, but you didn't purchase it. That is abandoned cart. That, by the way, let me tell you, this is a big, big headache for all the companies, e-commerce companies, that their abandoned cart is growing. So they want to clear it off. Here's a tip. If you want to buy a product and you're not in a hurry, put it in your abandoned cart, in your cart in Amazon and wait for it. Sometimes there are chances that you might get a coupon because the vendor, or let's say in this case, Amazon, might want to empty their cart. So they might incentivize you to give empty that and might provide you coupons. It has happened with me one or two times. So as a practice, if I'm not in a mood to purchase, but I put it in my cart and leave it and forget it. Sometimes they come back and sometimes they don't. So you can always try it. What else? Birthday journeys, follow-ups, path optimizer, which I'll talk about. Other ones, onboarding, a welcome journey. So this could be a scenario for a single send, where welcome journey, if somebody has registered in your website, you can use this template to create a single journey one time. So these are all the templates that are provided. Now, what I do next? Create a journey. Okay. So in a single, this is by my definition of journey builder. It's a canvas out there. It's like a painting and a canvas where you can draw your picture. That's all journey builder is. And the picture will be, of course, towards getting more subscribers, getting more people onto register to your list or access your list. So basically the idea is to paint a picture of a campaign the way you want to do it. And that's what Journey Builder is all about. It's a canvas. It's an open sheet. Draw your picture of a campaign. That's what marketing Journey Builder within Marketing Cloud stands for me. Okay, so what are the three options? Multi-step journey, single send journey, and transactional journey. So I'll cover each one of them and then we'll jump into multi-step journey as an example. So what is a multi-step journey? Multi-step journey is where you can do multi-steps. You can send emails on multiple occasions. You can do multiple things, not only one. So basically, for as simple as that, you can send 2 to 3 emails in one single journey. Okay, that is what multi-step it. On the same line, single send journey, as the name suggests, it can only send one single personalized message. That's it. That is single send. And transactional, okay, so based on if there is any event that has occurred, as I said, if you have made a purchase, you can send a transactional send journey with the help of that. Okay, so that is the difference between three types of journeys. And these are the different channels which are mentioned over here. So if you can see, this is email, this is push notification. Push notification is if you have an Amazon app, they keep on pushing messages to you on the app. That is what the push notifications are. And email is, of course, standard email. And rest all could be SMS and other advertising channels as well. Okay, now multi-step journey. What do? I click on build. And this is the right-hand side, the blank canvas I was talking about. Okay, so this is the blank canvas on the right-hand side. And with the help of left-hand side activities, flow controls, all the icons over there, which I'll be talking about, you can click and drag simply over there and then start creating a journey. As simple as that. The way you want to define it. In some cases, it won't allow you. In some cases, if you are putting it at a different place, you click and drag from the left-hand side and start adding them. Simple. I'm just showing this. This is no relevance, logical relevance, but yeah, I'm showing you that. So this is how a simple journey can be created. Simply by clicking on the left-hand side, choosing the activities, flow controls, entry sources, and then creating, configuring each icon or each activity, each flow, and then starting it. As simple as that. If you remember last time, I've been stressing on the fact Marketing Cloud is different to other Salesforce clouds from the fact that the end users are very less technical. They cannot write SQL queries. They cannot do heavy data segmentations. They cannot do API codings or AMP scripts. So this tool is designed to keep in mind that everything as much as possible should be standard out of the box and configurations, no customizations. Configuration means click and drag, the way I just done it. Customization means you make a change with the help of a code or an API at the back. That is the difference between configuration and customization. Start using those lingos in your day-to-day conversations, customization, configuration. Okay. Okay. So now let's get on to the left-hand side entry sources. So let me delete all of them and then I'll okay, so this is empty now. So what is event entry sources? Entry sources, and this is something over here on the tab as well, which I said we'll be covering. So these are the starting point of a journey. How does the journey starts? These are all six options that are provided as a part of entry sources. So bear in mind always that the options that are enabled for me in this org is based on. Just give me a moment. Apologies for that. Work for home, you know, everybody is in some way or the other affected by it. So yeah. I was talking about entry sources. So these entry sources are data extensions, which is a very common one. And I'll take this example, but I'll describe other ones as well. Data extension is a table, as I spoke last time. And the data, the table will store certain records of subscriber. And that's how you want those subscriber to enter into this journey. Okay, so that's simply click and drag. Click on this, select a data extension from the list of data extensions. So for example, this is a data extension and just select one of them, customer data. So that's what it is, it's done. So I've configured this journey and then I'd have to schedule it. Schedule it, I need to run it once, one single time. I need to keep it recurring or there is an, with the help of automation, I can do that. There's a third option over there. So if I choose recurring, I need to schedule, set the schedule. So start date, let's say I'll put today only. What is the time? Let's put 11 the night time zone. And I can set the options of hourly, running it, recurring, daily, weekly, let's say weekdays. Weekdays, and it has to end after, let's say, 3 occurrence summary. Okay. And then next important thing is contact evaluation. What is a contact? Contacts are all the subscriber or customers or the prospects who are entering this journey. So the options are evaluate all the records every time you want to evaluate records which are entering the journey, or you want to set a configuration which says that only new records, the first option, will be evaluated. If you keep on adding to that data extension, only new records will be evaluated, or every time all the journey runs, it will be evaluating all records. So look at it from this perspective. Keep on getting registrations in your website, and that resistance is getting populated into this data extension, customer data. Now, and you are running it on a weekday basis. So you want to make sure that in the first instance, there are 100 records, and on the next week, it becomes 200. So you want to make sure that it runs on the only new 100 records or all 200 at the end second time. So that is the configuration that you can set over here. Okay, then I'll summarize that. I'm done. So this is the entry part. What are the other options? API entry. An API can be triggered from an external system to start a journey. You can use this. This is an audience. Cloud Pages is another feature in Marketing Cloud, with the help of which you can activate or start a journey. Then this is Salesforce data. Salesforce data is nothing but data from Salesforce CRM, Sales Cloud, Service Cloud. So remember, I've spoken about the fact that with the help of MCC or Marketing Cloud Connect, you can actually get the data from CRM into Marketing Cloud. That's where this entry point comes into picture, where if you select and use that, you can configure it to which object you want to listen to. So if there is a change in lead, you want to trigger the journey. That is what it can do. That is the power that configuration wise you can do that. And it's there's an event as well. If there is a particular event that is triggered, you can do that as well. So these are the other aspects of an entry source. Now, what is next? Next is what are the messages that you can use to send? So the messages is push notification I spoke about. That is inbox, again, inbox, then in-app messages, and then email. Okay. So I'll choose email over here. Okay. And then I'll click on this email. Now I need to configure this email. And when I say configure, I need to choose which emails to be sent. Just like the data extension I had chosen, I can select which email from the content builder, already stored emails I'll be choosing. And then there are certain other configurations. So I'll just quickly select a message from content builder emails. Hopefully I'll get some of them. Let's say demo one. Yes, this was the one that I created. And then I have to configure the message. So configuration, is it commercial or transactional? I spoke about it. What are the delivery options, advanced options, all those configurations, and there is a validation issue. Okay, see, these are all the delivery options that are provided. Okay, all publication list, I'm using all subscriber, and all those options are already provided. And if I click on now, resolve validation to save, resolve validation. Okay, so I need to, okay, one more thing. Good, I got reminded of it by an error. You have to manually save this journey every time. It doesn't save on its own, auto save. So remember, you have to save it every time you do a certain step. Just like Outlook, you have to keep on control S if you're not working on a shared world. So that is the whole advantage of that. And then if I cancel it for the convenience of the time, that's how I'll be doing it, configuring the email and then saving it. Other aspects are, quickly I'll touch base upon advertising. These is as related to the advertisement studio within Marketing Cloud. And you can choose them if you require, but it's a different use case, which I'm not planning to cover in today's introductory session. Then these are very important parts of flow controls. What is a flow control? How to control your journey. That is what it's all about. So if you see, this is one day I've configured, it will wait one day. After sending the email, it will wait one day and then exit. That is one of the ways of controlling it. You can also choose wait until duration date. So basically what it can do is, for a particular day, if you send an email, wait, let's say 31st of January, that you can set. Wait by attribute. You can also do that, wait by attribute. Let me see if I can select it or not. It's not, okay, over here. By the way, it's semantically configured to allow you to only append those activities at certain places. You cannot do it at any place. So let's say wait by attribute, I'll show you quickly. Select an attribute. Attribute is nothing but a context, contact data, impact Saturday, customer. This is a table that I had created, date of purchase. So basically what it is saying is, I need to do the attribute. Okay. Cost contact data is customer purchase, date of purchase. So it, for me, it is saying wait for this date of purchase as an attribute. So date of purchase is a certain date. It has to wait for that date. So that is the level of configuration that is provided as a part of this activity. Very important one, decision split. Decision split is very important. We use it a lot of times, where what happens is, based on certain factors, you can decide which path it needs to go. So for example, path one. So if the country is, for example, I'm just, so basically it's filtering. If the country is equal to India, for example, okay, done, summary. Then go to this path. That is what I'm just trying to configure. If the attribute or the contact for that particular, so remember this 100 people, remember we spoke about 100 people will enter this journey one at a time. I mean, parallelly as well, but all of them will enter. Now at this stage, they will be checked against if the country is India. then enter this. If not, then enter this path. That's how, based on the attributes, you can define which path it will take. And over here, you can again consider sending emails to the people who are from India or from another country. Good use case would be the language. So for example, if you are creating a journey for global market, you can put a decision split saying that, that if it is from Indian domain, send a Hindi email. If it's from France, the country, send a French email. You can configure different emails, and that's how you can utilize this concept of decision split. Then what else? Engagement split. Again, this is also very important and we use it multiple times. Let me delete it and then show it to you. Engagement split. Okay. So engagement split, what it says is, based on the engagement, what is an engagement? I spoke about it. An engagement is whether I have opened the email, I have clicked on a link. Those are different engagement parameters which are provided out of the box. And as soon as you configure it, right now it's not getting enabled because I have to select an email message based on which only it will show the engagement, whether I have opened it. If I have opened it, that means I need to go into this path. If I have not opened it, I need to go into this path. That's how the journey is decided, where it says that if it is open, go to this path. If it is closed, go to this path. Okay, so that's the engagement split, and based on which it adapts, the journey adapts to the customer demands. So an example which I'll quickly create from a visual perspective and show it to you as well. And this is all about creating a nurturing, simple nurturing journey. By the way, who all are aware of a nurturing journey as a concept? What is a nurturing journey? Can I guess yes or no for nurturing journeys? If everybody is aware of it, or people are not aware, no, 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 yes, no, yes, anything on that lines? Okay. So nurturing journey is a digital marketing term. And what it means is you are nurturing the subscriber or the contact or the prospect or the customer, in that case, anyone. Nurturing comes from the word of actually doing it from the perspective of nurturing a plant. You do it step by step. Nurturing a plant, make sure it grows. That's the philosophical parallels with that. So basically, when I say nurturing, so you have got a list of subscribers who are interested in your products or services, for example. So you send them one single email first time. Okay. Based on their engagement, you see whether they are interested in your products or services or not. What is an engagement? Engagement could be they have opened the email or they have not. Two paths. So if they have opened the email, you want to set them up for the next step. So basically sending very exclusive list or services or any white paper, which is only produced for very elite people or your products and services or your customers. Or if they haven't opened it, you can send a reminder email to open that previous email. So this is a nurturing campaign based on which you can devise a structure. So TJ is asking, can we pause or stop the journey once it is activated or some steps are completed? Yes, you can pause or stop the journey at any point in time. Technically, yes. Okay, moving on. Next one is basically talking about coming down. There are a lot of other aspects which are presented over here or not presented over here, depending on my access. Remember that. And going a step above, Journey Builder is not out of the box. Either based on the additions which I spoke about in session one, it could be available with you or it cannot be available. So you have to directly purchase it or not. So that is something that you need to be careful about. Not necessarily everybody has got it enabled, Journey Builder as a feature within Marketing Cloud. Another important aspect comes on the left hand side, which is about Sales or Service Cloud. For this, you need to connect your Marketing Cloud with a MCC connector, which is Marketing Cloud Connect. So your Salesforce CRM as well as your Sales and Marketing Cloud are connected. Then you can use this. And what could be a use case? If I use the same parallels, now that particular person is interested in my email that I could see, I could convert him as a potential lead. And that lead, if I add it over here, that lead gets created into Salesforce CRM, because leads aspect is taken care over there. Marketing side is over here. So there's a segregation, clear segregation between marketing activities and sales activities. And going by the definition, they should be in the separate systems. So what we are doing is, if the person has opened your email, that means he is interested in your product and services. Why don't you create a lead out of it, assign it to a particular sales rep who can actually chase it for particular follow-ups and try to convert that into a customer, potential customer or customer. So that is the use case for a lead. And similarly, you can create an opportunity, you can create a case. Very typical example of a case would be, like, for example, if somebody has highlighted something, some issue, you can directly create a case from here into service cloud, CRM aspect of it from here itself. You can create an account, you can create a contact. Similarly, all the activities can be done from here to the Salesforce CRM side as well. So this is one of the ways. If you remember, I spoke about the fact that there is no out of the box way to actually send data from Marketing Cloud to Sales Cloud. From Sales Cloud to Marketing Cloud, you can do it via synchronized data extensions. I spoke about it last time in detail. But from Marketing Cloud to Sales Cloud, there is no out of the box way. So this is one small way to send the data from Marketing Cloud to your Sales Cloud. Although it's only case by case basis, but yeah, in a way you can technically send the data from SFMC to CRM. So that was about all the activities over here. What I'll do is I'll quickly create a visual graphic of a small nurturing journey for you to explain my whole end-to-end process. Okay, so I've added this email. I've waited one day, then I've seen the engagement. And again, I will send again an email to him. Okay, and then I'll put an engagement over here again. Okay, so basically, after at least one of the message activities. Okay, so basically what it is advising me is to put the engagement activity after an email. Okay, so it's asking me to wait. So basically, let me delete that for now. Okay, so again, I have put an engagement split over here and I'll add an email over here. I'm also joining them back. Okay. Fine. So what I have, okay, one more activity is remaining. Let me create a lead out of it. Okay, so if you can see what I've done is, let's remove this. This is an example of a nurturing journey that I was talking about. And I'll take a full use case, end-to-end perspective, and try and explain you what from a business perspective has happened. So, and I'll remove this one, right now not required. And zoom out a bit. Okay, so what has happened is, now that you have got a list of 100 people in a data extension called customer data, which needs to be nurtured. When I say nurtured, you might have got it that these are passive customers or passive subscribers, not even customers, whom you need to nurture so that to check whether they are ready to buy your products or services or not. So that is stored in, let's say, 100 records for our use case is stored in customer data. And now I'm running that journey on a weekly basis. I send them first email, okay? And I'll wait for one day. These days, this is for your purposes, but these days are generally in weeks or months. Okay. I check the engagement, whether they have opened it or not. So basically, if it opens, it goes in this path. If they haven't opened the email, it goes in this path. Now, if they haven't opened it, so this is this part where we can send the reminder email to open this particular email. So send another reminder. If they have opened, that means they have a certain level of engagement. Okay. That they have opened this email. Again, I'll wait for one day for the system to collect all the engagement. And then again, I'll put an engagement split just to make sure whether they are really engaged or want to make a purchase for our products and services. If that is the case, what we'll do is, again, I'll send an email for the people who have opened the previous email. Remember, they've opened these two emails. So as an optional step, if I want, I can put another email, make sure to check whether they are really engaged. And if they are really engaged, that means they have opened 3 emails from me in this path. That means they are a prime prospect to buy or purchase our services. In that context, they should be created as an opportunity, or I would say, in fact, lead in this, not even opportunities. Let me create it as an opportunity, because they have opened 3 emails. So based on your business process, you actually create a lead and opportunity for those type of prospects. Okay. So that's how this path talks about. He's opened 3 emails. He's engaged. He's a good subscriber, potentially good subscriber. Could be a opportunity or a lead depending on your process. Let's go to next path. If he hasn't opened it, remember we spoke about sending the reminder email. What if he doesn't? Well, we have joined these 2 paths. And what is the second path? He has opened first 2 emails, but he hasn't opened the next 3rd email. So we are exiting him. So basically we are not doing anything after that. So basically this path, the contact which enters this path, basically what we are saying is these are not interesting in buying our products or services. So we exit them. On the other hand, these are the different, these are the contacts which have entered this path are potential leads or opportunities for us. So go and create an opportunity into Sales Cloud. That is what is the use case with the help of this simple nurturing journey that I wanted to talk about. And that's what I wanted to cover quickly. And now I'll be open to questions now. Okay. So I can see a couple of questions. Let me see. Saiteja is asking, while journey is running, shall we add the data? Don't do that. Pause the journey, create a new journey, and then make any changes to that. Or rather, stop the journey if that is the use case you are asking. Sakir is asking, after activating the journey, can we see which step it is in? Yes, you can. So basically, once you activate the journey, you can see how many contacts have passed at which stage. So that is a good UI aspect that you get, with the help of which you can see, let's say in this example, if I come back, so you can see how many contacts have gone through this email, how many gone through this email, how many gone through this, that is an aggregate number. And then you can go into this history tab and see all the details, field level details for each contact, so that you can do, and you can use the filter over here. Okay, so that you can certainly do to a very great granular level. Does subscriber have, so TJ is asking if I'm getting the, can we see this? Then TJ is asking, does subscriber have any information if it is in activated journey, or we should not send more emails to him or her? TJ, I didn't get your, does subscriber have any information that if it is in activated journey? I'm not sure what is the context, but what I'm assuming is you want to know whether the contact has entered the journey or not. You can get that information with the help of this journey history. Okay. You can get to know as a marketer whether that particular contact has entered this journey or not. Although it's not straightforward, but yes, certainly you can get that information. And since there are a lot of people asking this question, give me a moment and I'll show you if I have that historic data with me. Apologies, I don't have any journey running data with me so that I could showcase, but these are records which are created and based on certain date range, status filters, activities, name of the journeys, you can filter them and get to a level to know whether the contact has entered a journey. Although let me admit it, it's not very easy to identify. It's not very straightforward to identify, but yeah, the option is certainly there. What else? Okay, so Avinash has asked a big question. Let me take a moment to see that. Can we set up members of a journey dynamically driven by Apex based rule engine residing at Sales Cloud? Here the rule engine is scheduled code which uses account and opportunity objects. Okay, the Apex code pulls the data from these objects, apply the validations and create a list of wrapper class. Can Journey Builder use the record of wrapper class data as an entry point? Here we will face two situations. New record are going to enter the journey, and second is old records which are already in the journey are updated. Okay, so Avinash, if you can talk, that would be great. But what I'm understanding is two things from your question. First of all, whatever validations that you're writing on Sales Cloud, can they enter in Marketing Cloud? Absolutely, yes. How? Multiple ways. One of the ways is you create a table or in Sales Cloud, for example, a custom object or a standard object, and use that in synchronized data extension to make them as enter into your Marketing Cloud. So that is the first part of the question, if I have got it correctly. Second one is, we'll face two situations. New records are going to enter the journey, and the old records which are already in the journey are updated. Okay, so these two are two different things. So you can handle this situation, but say new records. Remember I told about journey, allowing the journey to enter new records or only old records. So there's some setting called over here where you can allow or disallow entry into the journey once or twice. So with the help of that journey, you can do that. On the call. Just a minute. Sorry guys, thanks for understanding. So Avinash, yeah, so first part answered. Second part is yes, you can create that setting whether the contact can enter the journey one time or multiple time. That is configuration that you can certainly do. And the third one in this is the old contacts which are already in the journey are updated. Okay, so this concept, without too much idea about the your use case, what we can, there's a concept called journey delta and customer data. So you can use that concept to actually make sure the data is getting updated throughout the journey. There are two ways to do that. So certainly there is an option to do your questioning, your answer just on a visual level. I am not sure what exactly is the use case, but from a technical standpoint, the option is there to do that, to get data from Salesforce to here, make sure that whether it enters the journey one time or he's allowed to enter multiple times. And then with the help of journey data or contact data, you can make sure which data is getting checked. Okay, so that certainly is an option, technically speaking. Okay, we'll move on. Can we debug a journey just like we do in Lightning Flow? Debug a journey, when I say debug a journey, no, you cannot. You can simply, with the help of UIs, you can see where the contact has entered. With the help of this historic data, you can see, filter out all the contacts, whether they have entered across a certain stage. And technically, the system tables, you can pull out the data if you want. So debugging is, this is how the debugging is done in Journey Builder in Marketing Cloud. Okay, so TJ is actually looking forward for Kahoot time. Then what else is activated? Anything else, anybody for related to Journey Builder, guys? It's already 12:05. So if you have any last questions, I'm happy to take it. Otherwise, we will move on to what is called Kahoot times. Okay. So I will, Abhishek is, if Journey Builder is deactivated, it will trigger in the scheduled time. What do you mean by Journey Builder is deactivated? Will it trigger in the scheduled time? Those two are different things. I am presuming what you're asking is it is stopped, or what you're saying, it was in future time. Scheduled, in a, absolutely, it can be scheduled in a future time. But what do you mean by deactivated? What do you mean by deactivated? Basically stopped. If it is deactivated means stopped, then no. Correct. So like stopped, no. You have to re-enable it manually, but if you want to schedule it in the future, absolutely yes. But after stopping, restarting manually, it's up to you. Great. Okay, Sushant, I think, okay, one Abhay, just one last thing, I think. How do we maintain the journey for different countries? If I mean, I want to target different country audience. From a very simple answer Abhay, would be to make sure that attribute is captured in the customer's data extension. So for example, if a customer has a country named India, France, US, etc., etc., based on the way that attribute wala thing that I showed to you, it has lost. I think I have lost that. Oh yeah, I've lost that. You can define that based on attribute, which is country. When I say attribute, it's a column in that table. Something like, if the country is India, use this email template. If the country is France, use this email template. So it's very simple to do that. Let me ask. In regarding deleting journeys, can we archive the test journeys to see all journeys in Marketing Cloud sections? Deleting journeys, okay. Can we archive the test journeys as we see all journeys in all? Correct. So Ashima, I think that is something that it's not there out of the box, wherein if you want to delete a journey, it's still visible in just like draft mode, as you could see in my historic review. So there is no way to actually delete that if there is something that I am not aware of. I don't think so there is one, but yeah, that is what the answer is, Ashima. What else? One last question I'm ready to take. After that, I'll hold the reins to Sushant for Kahoot. So it seems Sushant got disconnected and he's joining back in any moment. Okay. So guys, there's one question that I was pinged as well. So let me do that Kahoot thing and then I'll come back to that question from session two. I'm not sure who asked it, but it was last time as well. It is related to subscriber list, but I'll come back to you on that. So still, I remember that question. I'm not sure which participant asked that question, but yes, let me do that. So is everybody excited for Kahoot? Give me a statement, excited, in the chat. Can I have it? Excited? Yes, one. Come on. Okay, Sushant, are you back or you're still out of the system? Okay, looks like we'll have some more waiting time. Allow me in. Okay, Sushant is asking me to allow me in. Let me see, where do I get an option to allow? Can I just give me a moment? Where do I see?
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, you are, Sushant.
All right. So sorry, guys. Actually, I have disconnected. My net disconnected. So,
Sushant, this is a good excuse I used to give if there is a question, difficult question to answer in the meetings. Sorry, guys. I couldn't hear you. Sorry.
Yeah. All right. So, Pankaj, have you completed with your answers?
Yes. There is
one question with that question, right?
Correct. Uh-huh. There's one question that I need to answer, but I'll come back to that.
Okay, then let me start the quiz.
And Avinash, I tried to answer your question just from a technical standpoint. But if you have some specific questions regarding to the use case that you have typed for such a long time, do get back to me. I'll be able to, I can answer you as much as possible. Ashima asked one question that I was going through, that can we link journey with a campaign? Answer is yes. And on the landing page of the journey builder, there is an option to tag it. So yes, you can.
All right. So let me share my screen. Hope you can see it.
Yep.
Okay. Guys, you have to visit www.kahoot.it, or you can also join this quiz with the Kahoot app. And on the right, it's showing the game pin 282-6605.
Come on, guys, we are 44 people in the meeting. We are still 22 only. Come on, we need to get 40 plus.
Guys, I'm expecting more than 40.
Come on, guys. What are we waiting for? Come on, come on.
Guys, I will wait for 20 seconds more and then we will start. So those who have not joined till yet, please do it fast.
Come on, guys. We have another 2-3 more people to join in. Or if everybody has joined in, if anybody is facing an issue, because last time I remember people were facing issues, if they are, highlight it in the chat. Otherwise, we will start. Couple of seconds.
All right, so I'm locking the quiz now and let's go with the quiz. Ashima joined in the last moment. All right, guys. So good luck and let's start with the first question.
Here it comes.
Journey Builder can be used for nurturing campaigns, birthday emails, segmentation of data, or A and B both.
Very simple. Come on, guys. It has to be correct from everybody. Good.
Good numbers. Good numbers. Yeah. Let's see the board. Shali Shin on. There's a tie, guys. We have a tie on first and second. Shalini and Gautam.
Super over.
And again, on third position, on fourth or fifth as well, we have tie.
That's good.
Yeah, it's good. Second question, guys.
Journey Builder is better suited than Automation Studio in what scenario? Engage base, emails use case, email blast, none of the above, or both? Which one is better? Journey Builder is better in which scenario? Oh.
I guess lots of confusion right. There.
So basically, it's better. It's better. Rather. The answer is yes. Technically, yes. 24th is correct. But which is better? Small wording difference. Yes, let's move on. Who is there now? Okay.
And
all new people. Sohail, Kuldeep, and Adrika.
Next question, guys. Question number three.
Can I trigger an email from an external API within Journey Builder? External API triggering or creating journey, starting a journey? Yes or no? True or false? Can I do it? External APIs? Yep.
Great.
Let's see the board. Good, Sohail. Kuldeep is again there. Ragni Pavina coming up. Good, good. So that's a tie. No, it's not a tie. Okay, second last question. WhatsApp integration. Okay, out of syllabus question, but enthusiastic one. WhatsApp release came across in which one? Which release?
Sorry for the typos, guys. It's WhatsApp integration.
Yes, it is WhatsApp. My bad. Good.
Good.
I was not expecting that, but that's good, yeah. Good, guys. Good show. Sohail, great. Anil, Mohan. Come on, guys. Last question.
So, this is your last question, guys. And Anil and Mohan, you have a chance. So, good luck. All right.
Come on, guys. Last question of the day. A and B testing activity. Again, bit of out of sight, but yeah. Come on. Which one is that activity called? Email, engagement, opportunity, path optimizer. Mm-hmm. Mostly a tie between engagement script and path optimizer, but yes, path optimizer is the right answer.
All right, so let's see the final results. On third, we have
come on,
Abhishek.
Good, Abhishek.
On second, we have Anil, and on first,
congrats, Anil.
Sohail, congratulations, Sohail.
Good one, Sohail. Great.
All right. So I think this was a tough game.
Yeah.
Today's game was really tough. Yeah.
Last two questions specifically.
Exactly. All right. So meanwhile, Sohail, you can share your email ID personally with me on this Zoom chat. And you can expect your voucher code from us within 1 or 2 days. Got it. All right, guys. So we have done with our today's session. And thank you so much, Pankaj, again for sharing the great content on this Salesforce Marketing Cloud with us, and on especially on Journey Builder. And thanks, and thank you so much. Like, because today's session consists lots of demos, and now we are I guess from previous session we are mainly focused on demos rather than having PPT things. So that's a great thing. And people are also asking questions with you, so which is good. And it's really, all your sessions are really interactive, I must say. And this is one of the series where I see lots of interaction among participants and speaker. So that's good. That's really good. All right, and thank you so much, guys, also to join today's session. We will meet again next week with our last session. So do connect with us, and in that session also, we will give you away a $200 certification voucher again. So see you all there. Have a great weekend ahead. Enjoy your day with your family. Stay safe, stay healthy.
Thank you, guys. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Bye, all.
Bye, all. Thank you.